So there's a rarely used but very useful feature in most word processors, including Pages, that allows you to set capitalization styles for some text. So let me show you an example. Here I have some text in Pages and I have a title here. And I've typed it out exactly like I want with capital letters in front of some of those words that make sense. I could select that and I could change the capitalization in two places. One is I can go to Format and then I can go to Font and then Capitalization, and I see options here. I could get to the same thing in the right sidebar by going to Format and then Style and then click on the little gear here and you see all the capitalization options. So none means that it should use the letters exactly as you type them. But you can change to, say, all caps. And this will make everything capital letters. Now, what's the difference between that and just actually typing the capital letters? Well, the letters aren't actually capitalized. It remembers exactly what you've typed. It's just styling it using all capital letters. So if I were to change my mind and go back to what I wanted, it remembers exactly how I had it. This is exactly how I typed it, with just three capitals. Now you have other options here as well. You can do title case, and what title case does is it's not going to change anything here because it's going to only capitalize the words that should be. So and in the, which by standard convention are not capitalized in titles, are not capitalized. Matter of fact, if I were to switch to none and change everything to lowercase like that, you could see that changing to title case will only capitalize the first word and then the words that are not common, like and the. You can also do start case. Start case will capitalize all of the words regardless of whether they're things like and the and things like that. And you can also do something called small caps. So small caps, let's switch back to how I had it typed originally. Small caps actually puts everything in capital letters but uses a smaller font size for the ones that are supposed to be lowercase. So we'll do small caps here and you can see how it's done that. And sometimes that can look very nice as well. But the key thing is it's not actually changing the characters you've typed, because you can always go back to none and it always remembers exactly what you've typed. So it's very handy. It's great anytime I need to capitalize everything. Like if I want to put this all in caps, I never type it as all caps. I always go and use the all caps option, and knowing that I could very easily then switch back to none if I change my mind later on. You can also, of course, use this in numbers in Keynote, and it's particularly useful in Keynote because you're very often typing things that then you want to play around with how it looks. So I can take this title here and I can change it to use, say, all caps or small caps, title case, or start case, and never have to retype anything.